So this is the circuit that we are going to build in the lab. It consists of a variable DC power supply, a voltmeter connected across the power supply, an ammeter to measure the current going to the motor, and we have a DC shunt motor. So as you see, we have the shunt DC stator winding, and we're gonna connect across it the rotor winding.
Before you start the lab, please make sure that you are wearing the proper safety glasses.
So this lab one, as we're gonna see today, first you will need to open the software, the lab board software. Okay. Then click on LVDAM EMS. And it will open the software for you, the data acquisition software. Just wait for it. From here, turn the controls on. The control voltage, 24 volts. And retry connection. Okay, now it's connected. Now let's open metering. It will open now the meters, as you see. E1, E2, E3 correspond to this here.
Mandy had to let us in today, but she did put in the request for access.
Then here we have I1, I2, I3. Okay. So now let's set up the circuit. We're going to set up the circuit for to run a shunt DC motor. Okay. So here we have a variable DC voltage power supply. 7 and N neutral. And this is the power for it, so we're not going to turn it on unless we connect. So first we're going to connect the power from here to the voltmeter. So let's do that. So try to use colors that are different colors so that you don't get the wires mixed up. Now let's test it. So I've connected now the positive terminal to the voltmeter, to one terminal on the voltmeter, and the negative terminal to the other terminal. So now let's turn on the power. Let's raise the voltage a little. So here between 7 and N you can see, so there's a voltage reading here, about 30. Now, on the data acquisition software, click on continuous refreshing. So you click on it, and as you see here, it will read the voltage in real time. So 40 volts, so that means this is more accurate. Okay. Now let's lower the voltage because I just want to make sure that we have that reading and turn it off and continue building the circuit. So now from the positive terminal of the voltmeter, the ammeter in series. And the other terminal of the ammeter connects to the motor. So from here, it goes to the shunt. So we have these. So this is a DC motor that has, there's a series winding, a shunt winding, and there's the rotor winding. So we're gonna connect it to the shunt winding on its stator. And since we're connecting a shunt DC, we're gonna shunt, we're gonna put them in parallel, the stator winding with the rotor winding. So we're gonna come from here to terminal one. rotor winding, and from terminal 6 to terminal 2. And we put this in parallel with this. Finally, we're gonna close the circuit. So from here, and go back to the negative terminal of the power supply. So now we have a circuit here. We are measuring the voltage. So this is going to be in parallel with the volt, with the power supply. Remember that very critical is that
isn't the
ampere must be connected in series with the circuit. Okay, so it's going to be in series. And now let's turn on the power and slowly increase the voltage. Time, so here we have, okay, the current must be DC, of course. So as you see here, we have 20 volts, and the current, you get a 1.2. Okay, if you can just switch, it'll give you positive. So as you see here, we experiment. And you can see actually the voltage, as the voltage increases, the speed increases. So the shunt, you see, a very well known method to control the speed, the voltage control, for DC motors.